I'm Chris Veltri. I run and operate Groove Merchant Records here in San Francisco, California. Started in 1990 by a couple named Mike and Jody McFadden. And it was from day one kind of a collector shop before there was really boutique shops, before that was even really a term. They started it pretty much primarily just with a focus on soul, funk, jazz, kind of rare Latin records. I'm gonna show you five records that have come in recently that are on the rare side, things that are representative of the sound that we like to offer here. This is a record by a local legend named Durando. It's a track called Didn't I? He recently passed away. He was known in the city here, but outside of the city, he never really, his career really never took off. We had been looking for him for a long time, trying to find him, some friends of mine and I, to figure out what other things he might have done. And for years went by, nobody can track him down. And then a friend of mine, Justin Torres, tracked him down. And a reissue came out of all his music and some unreleased music. But this is the one, Didn't I? One of the best ballads from San Francisco, definitely. Didn't I give you everything? This is another record, great soul album, Sam D's The Show Must Go On. It has one song that's kind of a mid-tempo stepper song called Child of the Streets. Another one that just comes and flies out probably the same week I get it in. Beautiful album by a guy that didn't do too much. I wish he did more. Your father is a pusher man. Yeah, you see, he's doing all he can to teach you the right way. So maybe one day. Here's another 7-inch that I just got in. It's on the Twinite label, same label home to Syl Johnson, Chicago label. This is a Package of Love by the Dynamic Tints, and it's just a really good funky, soulful ballad. Another one that'll be in and out the door probably in a few days. Yeah, this is another record that I like getting in. I never get it. I maybe get it once a year if I'm lucky. It's by a guy named Donald Austin. It's called Crazy Legs. And it came out on one of my favorite funk labels, Eastbound, that was kind of a unique label that let more jazz-oriented artists that were on Prestige, like Melvin Sparks, Houston Person, try to make a funk record. And that's kind of what this is. It's a funk record. Yeah, it's great. It's solid and kind of epitomizes what we like to carry here at the shop. So this is a local boogie record, soul record, kind of funky. And the way I found out about it was there's a local R&B kind of quiet storm station called KBLX that was located in the East Bay over in Berkeley. And they were having a sale of all the vinyl from the station. And I caught wind to it way after the fact. And some of the bigger stores had already been in there, and they had seen that there was no Rolling Stones or Velvet Underground, so they were just like, we're fucking out of here. They left. And I maybe came in 2 weeks after the fact. And right when I walked in, there was just amazing stuff just sitting on the ground. There was a $300 soul record just sitting there, and I was like, how did they leave all this stuff? So I started going through it, and it was great. There was just amazing records just left in there. Really, everything was $5 a record. And I came across this record by Twilight, and I was like, wow, I don't think I've ever seen that. Tried to track this guy down, Lawrence Ross, and it took 3 years of just calling his ex-wife, other members of the band, nobody knew where he was. We finally found him, and he was up in Vallejo, and he was super cool, and he had copies of this and his other record, and we set up a reissue for them through Love and Hate, and they were released to the public again.